Runcy and this is Runcy Reads. Today I'm going to be doing a book review on The Ocean at the End of the Lane by Neil Gaiman. This story follows a man who returns to his hometown where he grew up for a funeral, and he sort of walks down this road and finds himself at the end of the lane where there's a pond, and he visits a house that knew when he was a little kid, and when he goes there he kind of finds himself being flooded with memories of when he was about 7 years old and just things that had happened to him at that time and related to the house and the pond or ocean at the end of the lane. This is one of Neil Gaiman's first adult novels in a really long time, but I will say that I haven't read a lot of Neil Gaiman. I've read his children's books and I have read Good Omens, but I haven't read a lot of his adult work. But as I was reading this, I felt like this was one of his kids' books. The majority of the book, meaning almost everything except for like the first and last chapter, are told from the main character's perspective as a kid, so when he's about 7 years old. So there is a lot of this book that feels very much like a kid, although there are some subjects in here that probably aren't suitable for kids, but it definitely has more of a feel of his kids' books, which I liked because I know that, and I know that I like his kids' work, so I definitely felt like that this one is sort of an in-between of his children's novels and his adult work like American Gods and Nevermore. I wasn't really sure what to expect going into this book. It is a lot more magical and mystical than I thought it was going to be. There is a lot of mystery around this book, which is why I don't really want to talk too much about the actual plot of this book. It took me a little bit to actually get into the story because I wasn't completely sure where it was going or what it was setting up. So it took me a little bit to really immerse myself into the story, just because if I don't know where it's leading, I don't have that urgency to get into the story, if that makes sense. That's just like a personal thing. Obviously, that'll be different for everyone. But once the story got started, I was really pulled into it and I was really intrigued to see where it was going to go. This book is pretty short. It's about 170-ish pages in this edition. There is a lot of magical and mystical and mythical things that sort of occur in this book, and there isn't really a lot of explanation about those things, which bothered me a little bit because these events would happen that aren't, you know, realistic in this world, and so you're just supposed to assume that they happen in this world. There's no explanation as to why it happened. There's no explanation as to even like why it's occurring in this book. It's just sort of like this magical thing happened to this character. There's no rhyme or reason for it, which is a little bit disappointing because I was hoping that there would be slightly more backstory as to either why this character was chosen or how it came to be, or just if this has happened before, which there is a little bit of a hint that these things do happen in the world and people just don't realize it sort of thing, but it just didn't feel as fleshed out as I wanted it to be. So in that sense, I found it a little bit disappointing, but Neil Gaiman's writing is so beautiful. Like, his prose is amazing. I felt like when I was reading this book, I was watching a painting being painted because he's so descriptive and I could see everything that he was talking about, which in some situations was kind of not great because there's some gross stuff that happens, or at least gross for me, stuff that happens in this book, and I was just like cringing at it. In the end, I gave The Ocean at the End of the Lane 4 out of 5 stars because I really, really enjoyed this book, but I still did want something more. I kind of wish it was longer. Neil Gaiman says in like the acknowledgement section that this was originally a short story that was expanded, which you can kind of tell based on how it's written, but I kind of wish it was expanded a little bit more. I definitely think this might be a good starting point if you haven't read Neil Gaiman before. Not that I'm the ultimate Neil Gaiman expert, but I feel like that this is short enough that you can at least get a sense of his writing style. And also, it might be good if you're someone who's not really interested in children's books but you want to read a Neil Gaiman book. This is also seems like a good entry point. So yeah, that's my review of The Ocean at the End of the Lane by Neil Gaiman. If you have read this book, feel free to leave your comments down below letting me know what you guys think, if you liked it, didn't like it. I know some people were kind of disappointed in it. So yeah, that's all I have for now. Thanks for watching.